Hi guys, so I recently saw the movie Tower Heist, and I'm here to give my review for you. So Tower Heist stars the very wonderful Eddie, I'm still Raw Murphy, Ben, I'm still Zoolander Stiller, Casey, I'm not Ben, I'm better Affleck, Alan Alda, and it's a really interesting film. It's like an Ocean's 11 comedy. But one thing I need to say about Tower Heist is that even though people are claiming Eddie Murphy's back in this Tower Heist film because he's back to the more rough, gruff, hit 'em hard comedian, I still don't think he's the reason this film works. The reason this film works is because underneath all the comedy, there's a lot of heart within this film. I think that one of the reasons Tower Heist is so successful is because it has a lot of big names, but if it wasn't really directed well by Brett Ratner, then the heart would never shine through in this film, and the heart is the thing that saves Tower Heist from being a bad heist film, basically. You really have these characters you can grow to care about. And they're all unique in their own way. Basically, the whole plot of the film is that, Ben Stiller's character goes out and he's a general manager of this place called the Tower, owned by Alan Alda. Alan Alda's character is a greedy man and managed all of his employees' pensions. And then, when he did bad finances, everybody who had a pension in the Tower as an employee lost all their money. So Ben Stiller plots with Casey Affleck, Eddie Murphy, and Matthew Broderick to steal Alan Alda's remaining money. And I think this film is very clever in the fact that what they're actually going to try and seek out is a giant safe where the money is hidden, supposedly $20 million. And I love the way they go about planning to do it and executing that plan. One of the strengths of good writing is that there are surprises here and there that you don't really expect. I love that when you're watching Tower Heist, you don't know what to expect. You don't know where the jokes are going to be coming from. One of the supporting characters, however, that I did not favor was Gabourey Sidibe. I felt like her accent was very put on and fake. I really think that if you're going to choose a female actress to be kind of funny, go for the heavy hitter. Try and get Monique in there to do it. Get somebody who's really, really clever and knows their way around comedy. I understand that some directors are trying to let Gabby Sidibe get her feet wet in different genres other than drama. But this was not the right film to start her on. I feel that with all the strengths that Tower Heist has, it has a few very glaring weaknesses. You don't really feel like the members of Ben Stiller's team are actually a team. You kind of see them all as varying personalities who just happen to want the same goal as Ben Stiller's character. That makes the film be kind of disjointed because you're kind of going into it hoping that that you got this ragtag team of good people who eventually become friends, but it really isn't that at all. It's just competing personalities after the same goal. And for that reason, it kind of kills the film a lot. I was going to originally give this film 5 stars until I saw that there was no chemistry between the different actors. I mean, yes, each actor does have a personality quirk, but it doesn't lend to the combination of a team. And that's a huge negative for me. So for that reason, I have to give Tower Heist 3 out of 5 stars. But I want to know in the comments below, did you see Tower Heist? Did you like it? What were your favorite parts? If you didn't like Tower Heist, tell me why. If you did like Tower Heist, explain to me what your favorite part was and why you liked it. All right, until next time, I will see you guys later. Bye.